Hey everyone, Carla from Run Again Rover, creating binge-worthy content so you can rock your dog's CCL recovery. Today's video is going to be about my least favorite to most favorite harnesses for your dog. I'm going to start with this one. This harness goes over your dog's front end. This harness does nothing to help your dog with their CCL recovery because the lift is happening at your dog's shoulders and front legs. We need to lift the dog's hind end. So this kind of thing, if you have this, don't waste your time on it. The next one is this brand, it's called Solve It. I think it's okay. The thing that I like about it is that the direction of pull and force is coming at the dog's hind end where it needs to be happening. The thing I don't like about this is that the band that goes around the belly is very narrow. What that means is it's gonna put a lot of pressure on your dog in a very short gap, a short area. That means that maybe it's not so comfortable. I like that this harness has little padded things around where the hind legs go. When your dog has been shaven and you're pulling them repeatedly, you will see that the inside of their thigh might get a little bit chafed, even though these are padded. So I want you to keep that in mind. And if you need to, you can go to any fabric store and you can buy a little piece or two of material that looks like lamb's wool. And if you know someone who sews or you go on YouTube and watch a video of how to do some basic stitching, you can actually stitch a little cylindrical tube that you would then slide right over these straps. And it'll really help to not get the chafing happening at the hind legs inside the leg where it's very sensitive, okay? This is an okay harness. This harness, Ginger Lead, is one of my absolute favorites. Why do I love this one? Because it has a very wide band that goes around your dog's belly, and you can see that. See how wide that is? The material is nice and plush. What happens with some of the less expensive brands that you can find on Amazon or in the big box pet supply houses like PetSmart is that the material itself is kind of cheap. And so what happens is that you have the band that goes around the belly kind of folding in on itself, it kind of pleats. And then again, you have that really narrow piece of material pulling your dog. It kind of cinches up. And that can be a source of pain. It can't feel comfortable, especially to male dogs, because don't forget, their anatomy is down there and they don't tend to do very well with a harness that pushes on their anatomy. So I want to show you one more thing that I like about Ginger Lead. They have a straight strap that is made for female dogs, and then they have the male version that has this cutout. And so that cutout would obviously be so that it doesn't put pressure on their anatomy and they would have an easier time peeing. When you are using a harness, it does not mean that you have to have the harness on the entire time. For female dogs, it's easier because they're gonna squat to pee, right? But when you have your male dog, what you might wanna do is you're holding on to the harness and then you can let go of the harness. You've gotta make sure that they're balanced on their feet. Let go of the harness, step away for a second, let them pee, get the harness back under them, and then you can go about walking again. This store that I'm in is called Dogs and Cats Rule in Doylestown, Pennsylvania. This is my go-to store for food and all kinds of really good products. You probably have a store like this in your community too. The one harness that they don't have here that I like a lot is called Help 'Em Up Harness. I love this one, especially for male dogs. It has a really good handle on the back end of the dog where you'll need to pull up, and also one toward the shoulders. So you can actually have two handles. This is really good if you've got steps to go down, not a ton of steps, but maybe if you've got like two or three steps, it's kind of nice to have two handles to hold on to, okay? That is it about harnesses. The best ones to get to help your dog move and to help you stay safe using the harness. Now, I want to actually talk more about that real quick here. When you're carrying your dog, you have to make sure that you have your own balance. That means if it's icy or snowy or wet outside, do yourself a favor, and I say this because I had a couple really good wipeouts while carrying my dog, and we don't want to do that, okay? They need our support. Really good boots, really good traction, or sneakers with really good traction. Don't go out in your slippers like I did. That's so stupid. You get the point. You want to make sure you're steady on your feet. If you get the harness ahead of time, which I highly recommend, make sure that you size it for your dog ahead of time, not after they've come home from the hospital, because then you've got to try and get this thing under your dog when they're not able to move as well. It's much easier to do it ahead of time, and then you actually get to practice. You can practice in the house, have somebody stand across the room, maybe offering your dog a treat, and then slowly walk over and have your dog get the treat, give them lots of praise. It will help you to get the muscle memory of how it feels to actually navigate around, and then your dog will get used to it too, so that when they come home from surgery, they're like, I've got this. If you like this video, do me a favor and hit that red subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.